What's good, everyone? It's your man, BIZZYBRON. We are back with another reaction. We are here with Moonknight Episode 3. And I am ready. I am stoked. I am here. I don't know what else to say. This show has been fun. I've enjoyed the first two episodes. I know a lot of people have had different things to say, but personally, I'm satisfied. And I enjoy that it's been very different. I love, man, I'm just loving the whole, just the different sides of this character. We got Stephen Grant, we got Mark Spector, and I'm sure there's more to come. So it's going to be fun to see what else we got. But yo, it's always interesting to see Moon Knight in general, just seeing him suit up. And after seeing, Mr. Knight, it was just so cool. And I'm just so excited to see more. So keep in mind, if you want the full reactions, you can go to Patreon. Definitely help me out if you can go follow me on my socials, Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok. We're almost at 100,000 followers on TikTok. So go follow your boy over there. And, I'm just excited to just keep up the Moon Knight content. That's what we're going to do. So, man, I really don't know what else to say. So, yeah. Let's get busy. What are we doing? Are they making fake passports? Yeah,
they've already been stolen. That's what people forget.
That's important. Can't forget that. You're not a thief if you steal from a thief. Loophole.
Have a good trip, love.
All right. Here we go. I do not share in their happiness. Oh, Mark is here. Let's do it. The thing cool about Mark is Mark wants them to know he's here. So it's gonna be badass.
Oh, shit. You killed him? I need to talk to that guy. About a dig site.
You're a little late, man. Here we go.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I'm ready.
We'll be dancing, we're fighting, what are we gonna do?
He's just a kid, okay.
Where's Shakalaga?
Oh, man. Yeah, why? Good to know Mark can handle himself. Oh man. Easy.
Mark.
Steven.
Don't do it, Mark.
Oh, that's so awesome.
Stop.
Oh, Steven. Wait, what? Oh, it's. We're switching it up. Oh, this is so great.
Kalam Arabi. Say the airport.
Just let us go, man.
That wasn't me! Let me talk to you for a second.
Yeah, they're so scared of you now. Oh, this is so cool. Oh, this is so dope. Oh, damn!
Where is Hero?
Oh, this is so good.
Mark.
Steven's continuing to get in the way, bro. This man's greatest enemy is himself, and that's... What? Oh, this is too good, man. This is taking
Steven,
a leap, like, greater than any of these other shows. Who was it? Jake Lockley? What are we doing? Neither of them remember doing this. I'm confused.
Take him to the ledge.
Praise on it.
No! No! Yo, this is the best MCU show. Nope. No way.
I thought it'd talk.
Can't you?
I suggest you start listening to that stupid pigeon.
All right, well, if we can't find her, dig it, we'll have to stop him another way.
And they'll imprison me in stone.
Well, oh, doesn't sound so bad to me.
See how you fare against Harrow without the protection of my healing armor. sending the gods a signal they can't ignore.
Ah, this is so cool, dude. This is gonna be the best episode, right? Hey.
The last time I spoke to the gods, they banished me.
We're inside the Great Pyramid of Giza.
Man's geeking out. Oh, this is crazy, bro.
I'm Jatsil, avatar of Hathor.
Okay.
Oh, this is cool,
goddess
bro.
Goddess of music and love.
The other gods aren't really his favorite topic.
Not even when they are old friends.
Sorry.
This is so cool, dude, really. Oh, this is just... This is opening a door to a whole new... Oh my god, this is awesome, bro.
Has Konshu told you how this works? Strange sensation. But you'll get
bro,
used
these
to.
Seeds are fire, dude. Like, it shows...
Oh. In attendance, Horus.
Oh, so he's gonna get possessed.
Defnut, Osiris.
This is so cool.
And Hathor.
Bear me your self-righteous threats. I was banished for not abandoning humanity unlike the rest
this is
of you.
So good.
We did not wish to meddle in the
what
affairs
are you,
of
the Eternals?
Man.
We will decide our best course of action.
Is he just gonna show up? Oh! Oh no.
Is obscured by jealousy, paranoia, and
he's a deceiver!
Do not trust the word
oh my god,
of shamed
bro.
God. The marriage certificate under the name Mark Speck.
Liar!
Employment records under
oh
the name Stephen
god,
Grant.
Dude.
I've seen him speak to himself.
Shut up!
Man is clearly insane.
Wow!
This is a deeply troubled man.
No way they're believing all this crap.
I need help.
Bro, oh man.
But that doesn't change the fact that this man is...
Wow, this was cool, bro, really. This is so cool, dude. This is the best episode. 100%, man. Uh-oh.
I hope you like attention.
Oh, my God.
Right guy, right place, but...
She's good, bro.
What the hell are you doing here?
I'm here for me and for everyone else who would die of Harry.
I thought she was gonna say I'm here for Steven.
It doesn't matter.
Come on, bro.
Keeping tabs?
They're watching him.
Could be.
That's an interesting little detail to give to him.
She's not amused.
Tell them you worked at a gift shop, but they'd never believe me, would they?
Are they jousting? What?
Good to see you.
But I can't be the only one that thought that was Terry Crews for a second.
I hope you understand this is more than a collection to me.
Let Steven out before you blow this.
Not a chance.
Wow.
All right, what do you see?
Oh, the burial practice.
Yeah, Steven will know what he's doing. Oh, this is cool.
What?
He's gonna actually have a purpose now. I love it.
Hold it.
Ah, there you are.
Keep him occupied.
And they were calling him useless. Oh, stop it.
What now is you give me the body and you piss off.
Damn it, there is no coincidence. If there's something that you know, you gotta tell me.
You'd make a star.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, yo, easy, bro. Oh.
Don't. Anton, stop.
Get on your knees.
Nah.
There's something really, really big.
Oh my god.
Whatever they
god.
Told you, I'm sure I can offer you something much more tangible.
Oh my god. He
my
has no use for it now.
She'll see you exactly as you see yourself. As unworthy of love.
Bro,
shit.
Wait. Anton. Bro, what is going on?
Ah, hammer out!
What the hell, bro?
Where is he?
Ah! Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah! Oh, it's so cool. Oh my god, this is awesome. Oh, yes.
Stop it. Stop it.
Steven, get out of his head, bro.
No. Give me the body, Mark.
Mr. Knight. All right.
You all right?
That's it. Time out. Guys, let's all calm down, yeah? We're all worked up.
Oh, you about
let's
to get hit, bro.
Let's all just chill the F out and talk for a second.
Who is he, Star-Lord? Oh, my God. What do you take the box? Oh, this is too good, man. Oh, my God. Oh, she's about to go hard. Oh, let's do it. Oh, she's a badass, bro. Oh, shoot.
Tick tock, Mark Spector. Tick tock.
Wow, man, I'm loving the action in this episode, bro.
Can't possibly be any secrets left between us. And then something else pops up, and it's like I've not known you at all.
Yeah, you haven't.
Bro, why are you trying so hard to hurt her? It's so mean.
We can't wait.
I can't wait till Mark and Steven end up being on the same page. Why was that necessary, man? Come on, bro.
All right, go ahead, you're in.
Cheers, thanks a lot.
Ah, right. Oh, it's okay. So good, bro.
Egyptians invented modern navigation.
Oh my God.
There's not a lot of landmarks in the desert.
Why am I so happy?
I remember every night.
Konshu. Oh man. Is he getting sentimental on us? Wow.
Do what I do.
Oh, this is so cool. It's so cool to see Steven actually doing this, bro. Bro, what?
I got it.
Dun.
29 degrees north, 25 east.
Hey. Oh, this is so cool. Caught you. Oh, they're imprisoning him. How are they gonna do this without the suit?
Your torment forced me. I owe my victory to you.
Shit. Is that it, bro? Ah, ha, 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 ha. All right. Fire episode. I'd have to give this, I'd have to say this is my favorite episode of the bunch. Definitely excited to hear what you guys have to say, but personally, the action, everything, what it set up, not even just for the rest of the season, but what it possibly means for the future of the MCU, I don't know, it was just really cool to see this side of things, and, they did a really good job with everything, and I honestly had a really good time watching this. Arthur, of course, this man has been a problem since episode one, but he's continuing to just do what he thinks is best, and he is, he's a problem, bro, like, for real. I mean, he really made everyone there believe that Konshu is just, a crazy dude. So, Konshu seems to be gone for a little bit. I don't expect this to be a permanent thing, but, it's definitely gonna make things harder, because as we got, earlier in the episode, he did mention, good luck trying to do this without my suit. And now it looks like he's going to have to try to do things without the suit. And, obviously seeing Mark Spector, Steven, either one of them, in the suit is always one of the most exciting parts of the episode. I really, really enjoyed the communication this episode, the dialogue between Konshu and Steven, but mostly Mark. This episode is just all around fun. It felt a lot longer than it was, and I don't mean that necessarily in a bad way. It was just that there was just so much going on. There was so much to look at, so much to take in, and honestly, it was fun. I mean, I know for some people it might have been a little overwhelming, but honestly, I had a blast just, you know, kicking back and watching it. You know, it was pretty interesting. I'm excited to hear what you guys have to say. If you enjoyed it, make sure you let me know what your favorite parts of the episode were. We're gonna be throwing some of these reactions up on TikTok like we usually do. Oh my god, I can't talk. We did that with the last episode, and I'm excited. It's crazy to think that we're halfway through season one. It sucks that these seasons are so short, but you know, they give us so much and so little time, and it's usually exciting. By the time this show ends, we're going to be hyping up some other stuff. This show is going to be ending, I believe, 2 weeks before we're getting Obi-Wan. So, the 20th, and then the 27th, and then the 4th. So, yeah, we're getting the 4th, and then we have to wait about 2 or 3 weeks until Obi-Wan comes around. I don't know what show we're going to be getting in between. I don't know if we are getting a show in between. At least not that I know of off the top of my head, but I mean, I'm still excited. I mean, it's going to give us time to just chill out and then I guess absorb it. Cause you know, MCU content and Star Wars content are things I always look forward to, you know, the most. Most of these shows just straight up put a smile on my face and I always enjoy it. So I'm excited for more stuff. What's the next Marvel show that we're getting? Is it Miss Marvel? I think it might be. But it's going to be fun. But there's a lot coming out, and I'm excited for it. Okay, so Layla. We started off at the beginning. Got to see a little more of her, which is fun because it was just her in the scene. And her and what looked like a family member. I didn't really catch on to that. But it was pretty cool to see her, you know, actually just, you know, be able to talk about how she feels and what's going on. It's sad to see her in this position, obviously, because it's like, this man, Mark, is just not a good communicator, so it's just making things so damn difficult, and, it's just hurting her, and it sucks to see that, you know, but, overall, I mean, it was just cool to see, more of her in general, because she is a character that does make, Mark feel more like a person, you know, gives him, you know, another side, another layer, other than just being a badass killer, you know, so it is cool to see that. The possibility of there being a third personality. We know that Steven and Mark aren't the only personalities in the comics. So, them trying to pull out more, just, you know, the possibilities over here, it's crazy, you know, they can do so much, you know. They could even make a whole identity, you know. They've already changed some of these identities. They've already changed how certain characters, like, for example, Mr. Knight are. So, you know, the idea that they could just make up a whole personality wouldn't be crazy to me. You know, I don't mind it. I'm loving it. I understand bringing characters to live action isn't going to be as smoothly as everyone might think. Obviously, you could do, you know, straight up from the comics, but obviously they're going to make things different. And I don't mind that. I enjoy everything I see, you know. I enjoy just the idea that we're getting these characters in general, you know, and it's like, I'm here for it. But, you know, seeing maybe Jake Lockley, I don't know, but clearly there is another personality that may be as brutal, if not more brutal, than Mark Spector, and that seems a little dangerous, you know. And you know, seeing that crazy fight scene, you know, just starting off in the beginning. We're in Egypt now, so it's just so just seeing these badass moments, you know, the straight up fights, just all of this happening, and you know, this man Arthur has a huge following, a lot of supporters helping, you know, trying to help his goal come out here, and you know, seeing the fight go on, it was pretty awesome. You know, there was a lot of extra stuff, gave me, I don't know, reminded me very Indiana Jones like. It reminded me of the scene, for an example, where the guy, like, pulled out the sword or something. He was, like, doing, like, I haven't seen the movie in years, but he was doing a little dance, and, Indiana Jones just got so tired of it, like, he just pulled out the gun and shot him instead of actually fighting him. It just reminded me of that with, the similarities of, you know, when Mark Spector was fighting the guy literally licked the knife. I'll probably end up putting a side-by-side comparison on TikTok or something, but, like, it just seems, you know, similar, you know, and it was just fun. I feel like you guys don't know what I'm talking about, and I don't blame you, because I'm just rambling at this point, But it reminded me of that. But seeing the fight, it was pretty awesome. I loved how brutal it is. You know, the knives, I mean, it's just a big step for the MCU, considering that I feel like a lot of the fights, I don't want to call them watered down, but they don't contain a lot of, I feel like, they're not as crazy as this was, you know? And I feel like there are scenes, don't get me wrong, Marvel does have some crazy scenes, but I think television-wise, this has been really fun, and it's getting me excited to see what other dark tones, or how brutal is this show willing to go. I don't know, I'm all over the place. My talking is all over the place, but I'm excited to see more. I mean, we're getting Deadpool in the MCU, we got Daredevil coming through, so it's gonna be cool to see these characters translate, you know, over into the MCU, and how brutal they could be. I don't know, I'm here for it. The kid died. I mean, I honestly didn't know where they were going with that. When we saw the kid and he kept mentioning it was a kid, my brain was telling me they're going to they might kill him because of it being, you know, a shock factor, it being shock value. I don't know. But, you know, then the idea of it being Disney, the idea of it being the MCU was making my head, like I was like, nah, I don't know if they're going to do it. And they don't often do it with kids. Like, with Black Widow, for an example, they made us believe that she killed a child. But then, obviously, they turned around and she was alive. So I wasn't sure if they were going to do something similar. I wasn't sure if he was going to be fine. But the kid ending up, you know, cutting it to the point where he's the one who basically ended his life. Oh, man, that was brutal. And just seeing Konshu, like having no thought about it at all. He's just like, no, I thought he would have, you know, I thought he would have talked. And that's literally his whole entire reaction. It just shows how Konshu is. But, I mean, I don't know. It was just cool to see more of Konshu specifically in this episode. I mean, the meeting with the gods was so fun, you know, seeing these gods kind of possess different humans or the avatars. It was just so cool to watch. And like I said, it was so different from what I'm used to, so I just had so much fun watching them and seeing that Konshu actually had a friend. I mean, that was cool. But Konshu being gone is definitely gonna be a problem. I'm excited to see where it goes. Arthur coming through, just so crazy how he seemed to manipulate the gods so easily, considering that, you know, when we look at these gods, we're thinking, yo, knowing it all, super powerful, you know, you think that they wouldn't be able to be played by a simple human like us, right? But that was not the case. This man Arthur was just walking around them, and it was just extremely easy for him to just, I guess, play with them, and it was different. But I'm excited to see how you know, this does play out. I know when it comes to reviews and a lot of different people that got the episodes early, they did say episode 4 had a crazy cliffhanger, and a lot of them have to wait until the last two episodes to watch. So, keeping that in mind, what they did with this episode was pretty nuts. So, if they're, you know, talking about how the cliffhanger for next episode is pretty nuts, I'm really excited to see how it goes. This episode definitely had the best action, so that definitely carried a lot of the episode for me personally. So, I'm excited to see, you know, how this does work out for the next episode. So, let me know how you guys are feeling. I'm so excited. I'm having a lot of fun with this dude, really, and it's gonna be cool. One of Konshu's friends did come in handy and help Mark, so maybe she could be an ally down the road. Would really love to see her, you know, survive past season one. If we do get a season two, I don't know, because I know this is being marketed as a limited series. I'd be down for that. I'd be here for that. So I'm excited to hear, out of all of the MCU shows, which would you want to have a season 2, because Loki is the only one they've confirmed for season 2, so as far as I know. So I'm definitely excited to hear what you say, because I know a lot of these characters, their stories are going to be continued in movies. They have a lot of stuff going on. Loki is rumored to be in, or I'm pretty sure he might have already been confirmed to be in, Doctor Strange and Multiverse of Madness. We all already know Wanda's story is going to continue there, so I guess that's season 2. I don't know. Falcon and the Winter Soldier. We are going to be getting a Captain America 4 from what I know. Of course, Hawkeye. That's going to be continued with Kate Bishop's character and future MCU projects, of course. And yeah, now we got Moon Knight. So we got a lot of things coming out, and I'm here for it. I'm ready. But again, I appreciate all of you coming by and watching the video with us. I don't know. This is crazy. This has been nuts, and I'm having fun. So talk to me in the comments. You guys have been awesome. Make sure you're liking the video. It definitely helps me out. And on top of that, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok, all the support does help. It really does. So if you can go follow me over there, it'd give me the opportunity to start going live more, specifically on like on like Instagram and TikTok. You know, I wouldn't mind going live. That way I know I can just talk to you guys whenever, you know. I'd be doing that more on Instagram if I had more, you know, more people over there. Once I do that, I'll start going live and we can literally just have like 10, 20 minute conversations literally whenever. So just let me know if you guys are into that. Go follow me. And your Patreon, we got the first episode up there. We will be putting up the second and third, you know, hopefully today. So head over there for reactions. And yeah, I'm having fun. So talk to me in the comments and I'll see you soon. Peace out.